You are a supervisor in charge of customs and enforcement in the eastern region. Paul Karatunga said the goods that were intercepted have value in taxes and fines of 230 million shillings.
We call upon the public to desist from the vice of smuggling because it is costly on the part of the nation. It is also costly for the business community. If you look at the goods we have here and the means of conveyance, they are all subjected to penalties and taxes. Yet, if the clients had gone through the gazetted customs points, they would have only paid for taxes.
Karatunga said owners of the goods did not pay a single fee in form of customs levy. He noted that smuggling is higher in East Africa due to the many porous points that are difficult to manage.
Kampala. The goods that were intercepted were en route to Kampala. Why they were going to Kampala? Because the market in Kampala is big. They normally take advantage of the market in the city business center. But the goods were also coming from Kenya, but their origin is in China. Kenya is used only for breaking bulk. They bring them in large volumes, they break bulk, they move them in small bits using porous points and consolidate them in stores. Then when they get means of smuggling them, then they consolidate them in trucks and then move them to Kampala without paying any duty.
David Philip Ofubo, the in-charge customs enforcement in Jinja, revealed that they also intercepted a Toyota Noah vehicle and 34 cartons of Itel feature phones, which have tax obligations of over 100 million shillings. Ofubo revealed that the phones were smuggled into the country through Lake Victoria and a vehicle carrying them was intercepted in Mayuge district. The owner is still being traced.
These phones were smuggled into Uganda through the lake. There is a place called Chitierera in Mayuge district, a few kilometers from here. We have our informers there. They were able to relay to us that information, and we went and we were able to intercept.
Story by Donald Kiria for the news in Jinja.